Today, the innovations on our immediate horizon include autonomous pickers. UK researchers have already created one that gathers strawberries twice as fast as humans. The challenge will be creating robotic pickers that can switch between all kinds of crops. Robots or drones that can precisely remove weeds or shoot them with a targeted spritz of pesticide, using 90% less chemicals than a conventional blanket sprayer. For the organic farmer, they could zap the weeds with a laser instead. This could have a big impact. The UN estimates that each year, between 20 and 40% of global crop yields are destroyed by pests and disease. Tiny sensors and cameras will monitor crop growth and alert farmers on their smartphones if there's a problem or when it's the best time to harvest. The Bonnie Rob can take a soil sample, liquidize it, then analyze its pH and phosphorus levels, all in real time. As a proof of concept for all this autonomous farming technology, researchers at Harper Adams in the UK plan to grow and harvest an entire hectare of barley without humans ever entering the field. Companies like Egg Robotics have already commercialized software that analyzes drone-captured infrared images to spot unhealthy vegetation. Then, like a real-life game of Sim Farmer, the grower is alerted on their device when a troubled area is identified. Machine learning is regularly improving the system's ability to differentiate between varieties of crops and the weeds that threaten them. Vertical farms are essentially warehouses with stacks of hydroponic systems to grow leafy greens. They're sprouting up in cities all over the world where fresh produce and land is scarce. The key obstacle here is the cost of energy and the toll using a lot of it takes on the environment. The upside is that artificial lights and climate-controlled buildings allow crops to grow day and night, year-round, producing a significantly higher yield per square foot than an outdoor farm. For now, though, only expensive leafy greens like lettuce or herbs like basil have proven profitable in the vertical system. And the jury is definitely still out on whether this is truly an environmentally friendly technique. Another advancement in indoor farming is the Open Agriculture Initiative, which aims to create a catalog of climates, so temperature and humidity can be set to recreate the perfect conditions for growing crops that would normally come from all over the world locally instead. This is an attempt to tackle the food miles issue. When produce is shipped around the world, it creates unnecessary CO2 emissions. Just look at where a few of the items you'll eat today were cultivated to understand how big of a problem this is. Researchers at Scotland's Rural College are analyzing cow breath. Exhaled ketones and sulfides reveal potential problems with an animal's diet. Thermal imaging cameras spot inflamed udders to provide earlier treatment to combat a bacterial infection known as mastitis, one of the costliest setbacks in the dairy industry. 3D cameras quickly measure the weight and muscle mass of cattle so they're sold at their beefiest. Companies have even begun positioning microphones above pig pens to detect coughs, giving sick animals the treatment they need a full 12 days earlier than before. Less antibiotics are used if fewer animals become ill for shorter lengths of time. And a system of just 3 cameras developed by researchers in Belgium tracks the movement of thousands of chickens to analyze their behavior and spot over 90% of possible problems. Aquaculturists at the Institute of Marine and Environmental Technology in Baltimore are developing an artificial ecosystem that mimics ocean conditions so that saltwater fish farms can be built inland. This would allow millions of landlocked people to be able to enjoy fresh fish instead of consuming frozen fish grown or caught on the coast that have to be shipped thousands of miles in refrigerated trucks that use a lot of energy. The most exciting thing about this experimental fish farm is that it's actually a closed system that creatively uses 3 sets of bacteria in different ways, so it doesn't produce any waste, and even powers itself.